Once upon a time, in a place not far from here, there lived six very ordinary children. But these kids would not be ordinary for long, because something happened to them one fateful evening that would change their lives forever. It was an evening like any other evening, except this one began at three separate houses, at three separate dinners, with one unmistakable outcome.
Yeah. here. Love of my life. You should be so lucky. Today we're having leftovers of the meatloaf from last night.
Wouldn't that make it leftovers?
No, silly. That would make it inedible. Yet here we are.
I love family dinners.
So, how was your last day of school?
Did you pass your classes and make plans with your friends for the summer?
Do you have any friends?
I don't need friends. I just want to be popular.
When we were young, we enjoyed something called camp.
Camp is a place where you can reinvent yourself.
Discover a whole new you. I did, and look at me.
I do. Every day.
And I appreciate that.
Oh, really?
No.
Where you can develop your special skills.
Your special talents.
That would be great. I can run for camp president. Then I'd be popular. Thank you.
But the question remains, what would you do with that power?
Well, I just want to be loved by my people, or as are often referred to, my peeps.
So, you're just feeding your ego.
Exactly. Are we getting a dog? Did you guys get a dog named Ego?
Ego represents the it in this case.
Mom, Miss Nodal is calling me names again.
Am not.
Am two.
Am not.
Am two. Am not. Am not.
Hey, Father and I are so happy to see you guys work these things out by yourselves.
So camp?
Super kids camp.
You know you're just doing this for the plot line. Get us to a new phase of kooky, wild characters. So you can face adversity, work through the villain, and turn home the hero.
Sounds good. What's your point?
Exactly.
Look, I'm ready to woo the masses. My good looks and charms represent both them and then as far and near, and leading them to a new tomorrow. I'm exhausted. Is it nap time yet?
Great. Couldn't be more happy for you. Camp for you and loaf for me.
Tis true. I am more happy to be the tortoise to their hair,
the yellow light to their green,
the
chill today. I gotta go.
Take your time today.
Okay, then. I think we've just about covered it.
I think so.
So the numbers came in and the stock options are even better than predicted.
And then Mel said, let's eat lunch, and I said, love to Tuesday.
And Frank said we should invest in the upside, so the bottom line makes sense.
And she said Tuesday's no good. Frankie's got an appointment after you have the Donuts.
Because we all know that the bottom line doesn't always represent the bottom dollar.
And I said, not Dr. Abel, he's got hairy knuckles.
Sometimes I wish I could just stop time, you know? Freeze the moment.
I think you're drift. I wish I could stop it long enough so parental units could actually listen.
Yeah. But if that happened, we'd have to be responsible for our own actions.
That doesn't sound like fun.
You speak the truth, my even-tempered cohort.
I try my best. I find the balance.
Okay, kids, I'm done with my conference calls and I'm ready for family dinner.
All right, everybody. Come to the table and get ready.
We've got a big surprise for you.
Super Kids Camp, a place where your child can grow, develop into the person they want to be, the person they hope to see, because ladies and gentlemen, the future is a bright place, and we're all going to need a little sunrise. So let's allow their little minds to expand and allow their little muscles to grow here at Super Kids Camp.
Shell.
Very nice.
The fourth beacon eagle, the super eagle, if threatened
or hungry enough,
will eventually eat the it.
Mmm, yummy.
Finally, all the way from yesteryear,
a master of etiquette.
You look lovely, dear.
Why, thank you.
And she's a master of manners. It is Dr. Frankenstein.
Hello, hello. I'm awfully sorry, but I've got an enormous headache. My neighbour's dopamine kept me up all night long with his yapping and his growling and his barking. Ooh, barking mad those dogs are, really. Anyway, I'll just ask you to keep your loud American accent at low. Thank you.
Please, everyone, introduce yourselves.
Well, this sure is different than any camp I've ever been to.
I don't remember if I've ever been to camp.
Of course not. You don't remember your middle name.
I don't have one!
Exactly.
Easy, child. Is there anyone to speak to your brother?
No, it's true.
I don't remember much. So my brain's already full. I filled it up.
He has to download some files before he can learn anything else. You know, memory issues.
Now everybody knows.
I think we may all have something special about us that, you know, not many others have.
I can run in a circle for 27 minutes.
Hey, that's something I'd like to see. In fact, you might be my perfect running mate.
Thanks, but no, I hate to exercise.
And a sense of humor. Today could be the first day of the rest of your life. You could be my vice president in my quest to be king of this camp. Say it with me. Home, camping, king.
Home, camping, king. Did you just make that up?
Mm-hmm. Catchy, isn't it?
My brother here has an infatuation with adulation.
Huh?
You know, he loves to be loved, he needs to be liked.
I have a dog named Ego.
No, you need to keep feeding your ego.
No, Mom said you'd feed him.
You have no idea.
Actually, I do.
So, who's with me? Let's go out there and stump him.
Oh, I'm sure you can stump with the best of them.
Do I sense a trace of sarcasm in your voice?
Is there an air of alacrity that permeates his purposes?
You should learn how to say what you think.
Not that what you don't think.
Oh, okay, Yoda. Sticks and stones, my brother. Sticks and stones. Stop. There's a reason you've all been here at the Super Kids Camp.
Ooh.
You'll see. We're all going to be tested. Even you, short attention span boy.
Hey, that's got a nice ring to it. In fact, you can be my sidekick, Gothic Girl.
Well, I'll take the name, but not the title, because if anyone's a sidekick around here, that'll most certainly be you.
Whatever, what's the use of?
Funny you should ask, because the tree doesn't fall far from the branch. You see, I don't plan this matter. Oh, no, I plan this matter. I'm the most well-liked person I know, and I promise to fulfill all my promises to be the person I know I can be. And because I believe this, I hope I can count on you for your vote this election season.
This is summer camp, Knucklehead.
Oh, okay. You know everything, don't you? Can a guy have a dream? A dream to reach for the sky? A dream to be someone special? And there in the sky will be some
clouds?
Yes.
And birds? He's not your speechwriter, and you're off topic.
Word on the civilization of the foundation is built.
Ooh.
Got that on a fortune cookie.
No.
You guys are funny. You know a lot, and you just want to be popular.
This know-it-all and Mr. Popular.
I do know it all.
And I am popular. Who wants to celebrate?
No.
Whatever. What's with you two? You're so relaxed.
What's the rush? Are you in a hurry to get somewhere?
Everyone has their own pace. Ours is just a little slower than your average turtle.
But there's places to go and people to see.
And places to know and people to like me.
The world's your oyster if you like seafood.
I like to let my friends in the sea exist without me or my ego. Needing to eat them just because I can.
The lobster is good.
If the roles were reversed, that lobster would say the same thing about you.
yesterday.
So clean it up today.
Oh, joy.
That's the spirit.
I don't think she meant it.
Just remember, kids, don't hold on too tightly
to what you think this might be.
Because if we don't live lightly,
we kind of drop the ball.
Speechless? That's impressive.
So, you just want be popular.
You need lots of accolades.
I keep my accolades in a toffee case.
Yes, but what is it about being popular that you crave?
What is it that makes you need affirmation?
He never got a gold star in kindergarten, and he's making us all pay for it.
It's very fleeting. I think I want it. But when I get it, I don't think I deserve it, so I give it back. And I thought I had a choice.
You do. So if I could translate, he's in over his head, and he'd like a little help.
Well, if we take a closer look at the superego, we can see that Mr. Popular was never loved enough as a child.
Then created his alter ego, Mr. Popular, to compensate for that which he thinks he lacks.
He has always felt somehow inferior to the competition around him.
I wonder who that could be.
Would it be the brawn or the brain?
Aha! Miss Know-It-All! What are you saying? That it's my fault my brother has a head the size of a school bus?
He's making up for the fact that you have all the answers. That you are never wrong.
It's very hard to feel good about one's own opinion if one's sibling is always right.
You see, Mr. Popular is an idea man.
Miss Know-It-All is the conscience.
The left.
And the right brain.
Finally, it all makes sense.
You get it?
Yeah. Can you say it again?
I do not my time capsule, jet-lagged little sleeping pills. Sister Slow-Mo Master, fluctuate the moment, and you, Sister Time Master, stop it all together. Is this a case of sibling rivalry?
Not really. We like to coexist.
She's the yang to my
yang. She likes to
finish her sentences.
She likes to
slow down till it all makes sense.
See, those that mind
don't matter, and those that matter
don't mind.
You've done it again.
Sorry about that.
Would the two of you mind not messing with my reality? As I was saying, you need to keep in touch with you.
Wait for it. You're out of the fan club.
Not the fan club! I love the fan club!
What gives
Meanwhile, back at home, our parents miss their kids. They wonder how they're doing in Super Kids Camp. So, they form their own Super Kids Parent Support Group.
Crazy, slow, lazy, low, where
weakness.
It's just that they're a little more squirrely than we had anticipated.
What do you mean, dear girl?
Well, the little one doesn't pay attention, and the other makes me want to iron.
And I keep feeling inadequate, because one kid is smarter than me.
And the other has his own applause meter.
And sometimes, we don't know if it's morning or night.
A.M. or P.M. These kids are special.
Yes, I know. Thank you, Carl. Thank you, Carla. Doctors, tell me about our little heroes, their idiosyncrasies, their weaknesses, what makes them tick.
Well, Gothic Girl is developing her mind tricks. Her ability is to allow her to manipulate the thoughts of others around her. And her brother, short attention span boy, can confuse even the most organized of folks.
Mr. Popular is blinded by his own image. He's obsessed with applause, and yet he makes it work.
I like him to chip off my block.
But his sister, Miss Know-It-All, is a walking dictionary.
And although he is not a bit,
they make a great deal of running brain.
Sheila, street smarts.
And he doesn't know any better.
Those torn kisses keep messing with morality. I don't know which way's up. I'm late, I'm early, and even when I'm on time, I feel like I'm in a different time zone.
Would you say you were discombobulated?
Thank you, yes! You're all a beacon of inspiration towards your profession. Now take them away and let them sit in the waiting room. Go!
Children, whose are for kids?
family dinners.
So, how was it?
You know, Mom, it wasn't too bad.
We saved the world from global domination.
That's nice, dear.
We always knew you could do it.
So, Pam, was it all you expected and more?
Did you find your inner chi and make friends with the wildlife?
Actually, we did. I learned sometimes it's good not to know everything.
And being popular doesn't amount to much. You don't like yourself.
Sounds like you guys really learned something this summer.
We did too.
We missed you kids this summer. And we like to spend more time with you.
We'll get to know the real you and the real you too.
Well, Mom, Dad,
if there's one thing we've got,
it's time.
Well, we've got time now.
Do you have time to tell us about it?
I love family dinners.
Me too, dear.
Wow, would it be cool to be a super kid?
Disrespectful, I'm sorry. No, it's amazing. It's amazing. Oh, it's amazing.